Hi everyone, welcome back to this tutorial on how to group nodes and connectors in a Blazor diagram. In this video, I will show you how to group multiple nodes and connectors programmatically and dynamically. I will also show how to add annotations to the group, update the group, and create a nested group. First, I will open an existing Blazor WebAssembly app, which has the Blazor Diagram component with three basic shape nodes in it. If you want to know how to create this Blazor app and add Syncfusion components to it, refer to the video linked in the card above. Here, I have defined the createNode method. Inside this createNode method, I have created nodes. Refer to the video attached in the description below to know how to create a node and different types of node shapes in a Blazor diagram. I will run this application to show the initial output. See the diagram canvas rendered with the defined nodes. Now, I will show you how to group these nodes. First, I create an instance for the class NodeGroup with the name Group1. I then create an object called Group1 inside the uninitialized method and define the ID property and set its value as Group1. Then, add children to the group using the children property. I add node 1, node 2, and node 3 as children. Now, I add this group to the node collection object. Here, nodes collection is an object that holds the collection of nodes. Look here, a group is created with the three nodes. Next, I will show you how to group nodes dynamically on a button click. I comment out the previously created group inside the uninitialized method. Here, I am going to use the Syncfusion Blazor button component, so import the button's namespace first. And add a button component by defining SF button tag. With a content create group. I then add a click event, onClick, with the event handler, create group. I define the event handler. And use the same logic I used before to group the nodes. Now, you can see the nodes rendered as a single node. When I click the button, a group is formed with these three child nodes. Each node has an individual annotation to it. If you want to display an annotation for the group, simply use the annotations property as you do for nodes. I will uncomment the group creation coding in the uninitialized method for further demonstrations. Let me add an annotation to the group by defining the shape annotation. And setting the content with the value group annotation. I define the annotations object inside the Group1 object. And assign the annotation object to it. Look here, the annotation has been added to the group. Like nodes, I can also apply styles to the group. To demonstrate, I define the style property. and set fill property with an appropriate color. You can see the group is filled with the defined background color. Now, let's see how to update the group dynamically. In this example, I update the position of the group on a button click. I add one more button. With the content, update position. And define the onClick event. With the event handler, update position. I define the event handler. And set the offset of the group to 500 on the x-axis. And 200 on the y-axis. When I click the Update Position button, the position of the group is changed. Similarly, you can update any property of the group node dynamically. Next, let me show the steps to create connectors and group them. Here, I will define a method, createConnector, and add connector creation code inside the uninitialized method. If you want to know how to create connectors in detail and customize them, refer to the video link attached in the card above. Now, I am going to add these connectors to the group by adding the IDs of the connectors to the children property of group 1. You can see the connectors are added to the group. Like single connectors, we can do customizations to these grouped connectors also. You can make the node group interactive by dragging and dropping the group nodes and connectors from one position to another. I can also resize and rotate it. When I click on any child node in the group, the entire group is selected instead of the particular child node. To select that node, I need to click on it consecutively because the selection takes place from top to bottom in the hierarchy of the node group to its children. Okay, finally I will show you how to create a nested group. Let me create a new node, node 4, by making a call to the createNode method with appropriate parameters. I then add this newly created node to the node collection object. Now, I am going to form a new group by adding this newly created node to the existing group. So, I will create an instance for the class node group with the name, group 2. I define the ID property and set its value as group 2. Then add the children to the group using the children property. I add the existing group, group 1, and node 4. I also add annotations to the group. And set the value as nested group. To fill the background color, I define the style property. And set an appropriate color to the fill property. Finally, I add this group 2 to the node collection object. You can now see the nested group created. Like the node in node group, you can perform all interactions on the nested group. In this video, you have seen how to create a group and add child nodes and connectors to it. You have also seen how to update and add annotations to the group and how to create a nested group. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use all our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.